Hello?
Marshall?
Yes, this is Connie Marshall.
I'm sorry, hang on just one minute.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that. Just as I was dialing your number, somebody walked into my office.
Okay.
So I apologize. I was returning your phone call.
I don't even know who I'm talking to.
I work with the Department of Criminal Investigations in Frankfurt. My name's Ed Price.
Okay. I'm trying to find out about the letter that was supposed to be sent to me to take to Human Rights Commission. I think it's where she told me that you all told me I need to go because it's a civil rights issue.
Do you know who was it from the Attorney General's office, or was it specifically from Department of Criminal Investigation?
Yeah, I thought I was speaking with the Department of Criminal Investigations. I sent you all a packet.
Yeah, no, I saw your packet, but I'm not aware of any letter that somebody was supposed to send about Human Rights Commission.
Right, I talked to a woman. I can't think of what her name is right now, and I'm trying to get to work. I'm sure I have it written down somewhere. And she said you all would send me a letter, but I haven't received anything yet.
I'm not familiar with that part of it. Do you want to, because I just don't want to give you wrong information, do you want to give me a call back maybe tomorrow and with that person's name so I can track down what letter you're talking about?
Okay, she said it was a letter stating that you all could not assist me, that you thought it was a Kentucky Human Rights Commission issue, a civil rights issue.
Yeah, there may be. Let me check on that. We do send out some letters, but I wasn't aware. So basically you're saying you were told that there'd be a letter saying that, because really there's not a lot from our standpoint. We do public corruption investigations. And so our office, we get lots and lots of complaints and referrals, and we have to sort through lots of cases to try to determine where to best spend our time and effort. And if there are other routes, a lot of times we'll refer people to judicial commissions, we'll refer people to human rights, we'll refer people to federal agencies. So I can't speak to exactly what you were told, but we do send out letters sometimes referring people to other agencies, and that may be what you're telling me.
Yes, that's what I was waiting for, but when I looked at your website, it stated that you dealt with public corruption, also dealing
right.
with the judges, dealing with the police, and any type of public corruption. And what I sent you all in that book included the judges and the police as well. You know,
and so I did, and I reviewed it. I looked over some of it. A couple of us did here, and you know, again, with some of the information you shared, there are some anonymizers that have been used with some of the emails that you've shared, and that there's you know, these cases are difficult, and we have to be very careful and selective in where we are able to put our resources so that we can make sure that we're you know, being good stewards of tax dollars too.
Okay, but what I sent had to do with about 8 fabricated forged documents placed in court cases, and one of them was saying that Judge Minton had performed cunnilingus on a 12-year-old girl. My name was signed to that court document, and I didn't send that court document. And they also said that Judge Hughes was a hardened lesbian with fantasies about me. I didn't send that, and that was signed. Then there was one sent to Judge Hale that said that he was taking bribes. My name was signed to that. I didn't send that. And there was a document sent to LG&E saying they were going to kill Tim Melton, the LG&E manager, and that I had a gun and a bunch of crazy stuff. I didn't send that, you know, and the list goes on and on. And then I received over 30 hate calls, sexual degradation, hate calls from the Louisville Metro Police Department. And they've named my children. You know, they're going to go after my children. They've called me slaves, niggers, told me not to testify in court, told me not to speak at Metro Council. The things that they talk about are things that only the police would know. And then a lot of the documents that were sent to me, they left LMPD, Louisville Metro police department as the people sending them. Some of them they rerouted through other servers or however they do it, but a lot of them they left their own name on there. Then I received numerous telephone calls calling me slaves and niggers and bitches. I sent that's in that book also. And then I received calls asking for Judge Sean Delahanty, which was one of the first courts that I was in which the first fabricated forged document was put in, saying that it was from my neighbors. It wasn't from my neighbors, gave them all a copy. And then I had a man come to my house, some white man, looked like some type of official, tried to break in my house while I was in the bathtub. I received an email from the police stating that they sent him, and the list goes on and on and on. And looking at your website, sir, I don't understand why you all can't assist me, because it has to do with public corruption. And if these judges are telling me, when they tried to make it look like I sent it, because the judges sent something back to me saying, we filed this in your case today, this pleading that you sent, and I told them I didn't send it, then none of them have asked for an investigation. How can you not ask for an investigation when people are saying that you're performing oral sex on a 12-year-old girl and you have, you know, lesbian fantasies about me and all the other stuff they said? You know, it's very suspicious that nobody wants to investigate after they can't make it look like it's me. You know, I could be in jail or mental
I will check on that letter for that you were talking about for the Human Rights Commission. If I'm able to get that sent out to you, I'll send it out to you.
I appreciate it, but if I could talk to somebody who's over that office, because looking at your website, I don't understand why you can't assist me. Department of Criminal Investigation. I just don't understand.
There's nothing further that we would be able to assist you with. We've looked at all of the information you provided and all of the information that was in your booklet, and we've done some other looking at the court records, and at this point there's nothing.
I also sent you 30 pages of the police at my home terrorizing me.
I got it all.
Okay, and you all can't do anything.
I looked up your the YouTube videos you have.
Right, because I provided the links.
I've done my homework. If I could just
get a letter stating why you can't assist me when your website says something totally different and referring me to the EEOC, I mean not the EEOC, the Kentucky Commission on Human Rights, I would appreciate it, because I briefly...
I'll do that. We'll get that letter out to you, okay?
I appreciate it. Thank you.
All